In this video, I'm going to show you how to do text search without using find or search. The requirement is like this. I have each row containing some text. Then I have to search for this particular word or phrase in each of these rows and find out how many times it appeared. In this case, I was only looking for one piece of text. What if I have a list of things to look for? No problem. I put them here and this gives me the total number of occurrences for each of these words across all the data I have. And one more variation here is I may want upper lowercase to be considered or ignored. For example, I'm going to search for video right now, V capital, the number changed. But if I say ignore, then the number will be different. So let's see how this is done. This is the formula. The formulas do look complex at this stage, but let's go step by step and you will understand exactly how to do this. The requirement is simple. This is our search text and this is the input text. So I don't want to use H3 and F3. We will give them names. This is the input text. This box here is called name box. I'm going to call it input. Just type and enter. This one I'm going to call ST for search text. Now, how are we going to go about doing this? Now, the natural tendency would be to use the find or search function. Find is case insensitive, search is case sensitive. But that doesn't work. Why? Let me show you. Let's use the find function. I'm saying find this inside this. Okay, fair enough. It will find it, but it'll give me a number which is not the number of occurrences that I would expect 2. But here it's giving me 10. Why? Because it's the 10th character. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It found the first occurrence of it. And it is not telling me anything about is the same word appearing one more time. So find and search functions are useless for us. Now we are going to use a different approach. First, I'm going to count how long the text totally is. So we say length. That's easy. There is a LEN function. Length of what? Input. Okay, easy. Now we will also do the length of the search text. Now what I want to do is look for the search text in the input text and delete it. So here, delete. Second here, delete. And then check how long is the input text. So how do I look for something and delete it? Well, there is a substitute function, something like find and replace as a function. So substitute says, okay, which is the basic text in which you want to substitute input? And what are we looking for? A search text, which is here. And what do you want to replace it with? And that's the important part. I will replace it with nothing. So if one here is gone, 4 characters less. Twice here is gone, 8 characters less. So this is the version without the word here. Now we will take the length again after search replace. That's 47. Now let's see the difference. What is the difference between the original length and the truncated length? That's 8. Now does it mean the word here appears 8 times? No, the word here itself is 4 characters. So if I want to find the word count, what should I do? Take this difference and divide it by the length of the search text itself. And that is how we could find the word here appears twice in the input text. Now let's make one of them uppercase. Notice it understood that this is not matching. So instead of 2, now it's 1. But we have done ignore case. That is not having any impact because in our formula, we have not used that at all. So now what should I do? So when I'm substituting, if this is ignore uppercase, I should say convert this to lowercase, convert this also to lowercase. So upper lowercase does not matter. Now how do I do that? Well, I'll have to do substitute if ignore case. So if this is true, then I want lower of input and otherwise just input. And same thing if G3, then I'll take lower of ST, otherwise ST, and that should do it. So notice if I say ignore upper lowercase, it's giving me 2 instances. If I say don't ignore, then it'll give me 1 instance. That is exactly what we want. Now we did it in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 steps. Now I can combine this whole thing in one function. So let's do this formula all over again. I want length of input text, of course, and then I want to subtract the length of search replaced or substituted text. Substitute input text with search text and replace with nothing, and whatever length comes, we'll get that. So we got 4. All right. Now we want to divide this whole thing. So I'm just putting this whole thing in brackets, and length of that should give me 1. Now let's incorporate the upper lowercase part of it here. I'm going to use another function called let. Let simplifies your formulas. I'm going to say X means input and Y means search text. Now wherever there is input, I can just remove that and say X. And wherever there is search text, I can say Y. Now here I can put the if condition. If this ignore case thing, then lower of input, otherwise just input. And same thing here, G3, then lower of ST or simple ST. So I'm going to say ignore case, it should give me 2. So essentially all this is no longer required. We just encapsulated this whole thing into this function, and that function is exactly what we have put here. Now, because we have multiple rows here, the input keeps changing. So that input is now at the red text, and it will keep changing for every row. And that's how for every row we are getting different output, and upper lowercase is also working. The same concept we want to apply to get the grand total here. I'm providing one cell at a time. Instead of that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give the entire range. At the rate I have removed, what does that mean? Entire column. And because it's an entire column, it's going to give multiple values, and then the sum function is going to say 1 plus 2 plus 1, and that's how it is 4. In this formula, the search text was hard coded, whereas in these formulas, the search text is coming from the current row. And that's how you do text search using formulas in Excel. If you found this useful, please share it with as many people as you can. Let's make the world a more efficient place together. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.